How's it going, guys? I'm Theo Joe, and if you didn't know already, the latest major update to Google Chrome has been released, which is version 79. And there's a good amount of cool changes we can talk about so you can know what's new. Google usually releases major Chrome updates every couple months, so let me know if you like this video and I'll see about making more videos like this in the future the next time a big update comes around. As usual, before we jump in, be sure to follow me on my world-class Instagram account with top-shelf tech memes. You'll literally collapse from laughing so hard if you do, so that's just at TheoJoe over on Instagram. And also subscribe to this channel because I make new videos twice a week, and enable notifications with the bell if you don't want to rely on the YouTube algorithm to actually tell you about it when I upload. All right, anyway, so the first big new feature is automatic tab freezing. This is meant to improve Chrome's usage of system resources such as the CPU and battery power. Basically, it makes it so when you have several tabs open, if there's a tab that has been in the background or not in use for over 5 minutes by default, it will freeze that tab so it won't use any CPU power or be able to perform any actions in the background. And the website contents will still remain in the system memory, so it's not like the tab gets killed, just frozen. So this is different from the existing Chrome feature called tab discarding, which was added in 2015. In that case, if the system is low on memory, Chrome will actually take the tab out of system memory and put it on the hard drive to free up RAM until it gets used again and then move back into the memory. So this new update is a good middle ground just to prevent stuff from running in the background, but it still makes the contents readily accessible, no delay the next time you click on that tab. Next up, we have a couple new features all having to do with better password protections. One example is Chrome will check if passwords you enter into some sites have been compromised and exist in stolen online databases. If that is the case, you'll see a kind of pop-up that will warn you that your password is out there and will recommend a password checkup if you have other passwords stored on your Google account, or at least to change that password. And this is basically the same technology as a Chrome extension released by Google earlier this year called Password Checkup, which does the same thing. So now it's just built in, which is good and should alert people who otherwise would have no idea. And as a side note, a great website you can use is one called haveibeenowned.com, where you put in your email and it will tell you whenever your email and login credentials show up in a stolen database released online. It's really important these days because new hacks are happening all the time. Also, Chrome improved its anti-phishing technology, so it's a lot more likely to detect and warn you about phishing sites. Google has always compiled a massive list of phishing sites and apparently is able to detect them within just 30 minutes of them going online. But these sites are tricky and can use methods to instantly change domains and other techniques where even 30 minutes might be too slow. So in this new version of Chrome, there's a real-time phishing detection feature, which can sometimes even detect phishing sites that are not in Google's database yet. It's not perfect, and they say it will be able to detect about 30% of sites, which might not sound like a lot, but remember, it's just for sites that are less than 30 minutes old, which are unlikely you'll come across anyway, and Google will surely improve this over time. Okay, the next feature is one I'm really excited about, which is DNS over HTTPS. And specifically, Chrome will be enabling this by default for a small percentage of users who are using a DNS provider that supports it. If you don't know what DNS over HTTPS is, I don't want to spend too much time explaining it in this video, but it simply encrypts your DNS requests, which is how your computer translates any URL you want to access into the IP address your computer uses. You probably already know about HTTPS, which is just when you encrypt the connection between a website and your computer so no one can snoop in on the contents of the website you're viewing or take any passwords or anything you send to it. But until recently, there hasn't been any way to secure DNS requests. So if you are on a public Wi-Fi or school network, for example, DNS requests could be monitored or even intercepted and redirected. This is how a lot of web filters work. But if the connection to the DNS server is encrypted, it can't be snooped in on and can't be changed or redirected. So anyway, how do you use this yourself? First, you have to actually be using a DNS provider that supports encrypted DNS. Two examples are Google's DNS servers at 8.8.8.8 or Cloudflare's DNS servers at 1.1.1.1. And Cloudflare is the one I would recommend. That's really the one I use. You'll have to look up how to set these up yourself, but you can just Google how to change your DNS and you shouldn't have too much trouble. And then in Chrome 79, you can activate the feature by going to the Chrome:// flags menu and then search DNS and look for the option called Secure DNS Lookups and just enable that. If you use Cloudflare's DNS, you can make sure it works using their test page, and it will show a check next to secure DNS, so you'll know. So it's really nice that this kind of security is finally becoming easy to use. All right, moving on, we have some cool new clipboard features. Specifically, you can now sync and move copied clipboard text between desktop and Android devices with Chrome. You have to be logged into Chrome on both devices, but once you do, you can highlight text on your desktop, for example, and then you'll get the option when you right-click to copy to whatever device name. It can also be done the other way around from Android to desktop. If for whatever reason it's not working, you can try going into the Chrome flags menu and then search clipboard and just enable the three settings you see here. In any case, this should make it much easier the next time you want to look at something on your phone or the other way around without having to email yourself or something. Okay, finally, there's a couple behind the scenes updates that are worth mentioning. First is that the older versions of the encryption protocol TLS are being deprecated. Specifically, this means TLS 1.1 and TLS 1.0, which are no longer secure and are really old, but nearly all websites have upgraded anyway. If you do come across a site using these, Chrome will now warn you that the connection is not secure, even though it's technically encrypted, because it's a very weak encryption. And in a later major version of Chrome, these sites will likely be blocked altogether from being viewed to really pressure websites to update. But again, this should be really rare. Okay, finally, Chrome 79 will get a new API called WebXR for virtual reality and augmented reality features on websites. Since it's new, this isn't something you'll come across really at all yet, but it will allow websites to possibly create web apps that will work with virtual reality headsets like the Oculus Rift, the Vive, Windows Mixed Reality, and others. So for example, off the top of my head, in the future, you might be able to open up Google Maps and then send the street view to your VR headset and then look around in VR, stuff like that. Should be pretty cool to see what websites do with it. All right, so those are the biggest changes in Chrome 79. Let me know what you guys think. Before you click to another video though, I realize I haven't plugged my channel membership features in like forever. So I should tell you that if you become a channel member, one of the features is you can see videos usually at least a day early as soon as I finish them. So you can always be the first comment if you want. But yeah, anyway, thanks for watching this so long. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend talks about different Google Chrome update channels like the beta, developer, and even canary versions of Chrome. So if you have no idea what I'm talking about, you should find it pretty interesting. So that link will be on the right-hand side. You can just click on. And again, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.